Hello, I'm here to tell you about my SuperM concert.
Focus.
I did record a little bit of footage, but honestly, I was trying to enjoy the experience, of course, like you should do at a concert, and not sit there and record it. Like, I don't know, like maybe 3 or 4 minutes of footage. So I'm gonna be posting them throughout the video, you know, just boom. To be able to go to this concert was honestly a miracle on my part, because I didn't originally have a ticket to go, but ask and you shall receive. On Twitter, I had tweeted out, it's like, please, I wish I could win some SuperM tickets or something, because I want to go and see Mark. I think a couple hours later, my friend Diana from Twitter, she had messaged me. She's like, hey, I have an extra ticket. You want to come? And I'm like, what? Ah. You know, the day of the concert, you know, she comes by and picked me up because, like I keep saying, my car doesn't work. When my friend had came and picked me up, she had this bag ready, and she actually talked about this on Twitter, and I was so curious about it. She was like, ah, this doesn't match with my outfit, so here you go, it matches with yours better. Because I was wearing this blue here, and my nails coincidentally were yellow, and I was like, wow, that matches what I'm wearing. So she's like, here you go, Merry Christmas. And I was like, ah, yeah, thank you. As you can see, it says Mark's Lunch Money. It took place in Fort Worth in the Dickies Arena. So we got to the venue, and they have, like, I don't know, tiered parking. Like, I don't know how you call it. It's like a parking garage or whatever, but like on top of each other. That day it was 30 degrees outside, okay? And I wore a teeny tiny jacket and Diana was wearing like this trench coat kind of thing, and she was very prepared and I was not prepared. We actually waited for an hour or two, like in the parking garage, because we got there early, because that would make sense, because the traffic would really pick up if we got there on time, you know. Once we finally got out of the car, it was 30 degrees and we were running to go to the building because we thought it was open. We got there and there was a super long line. Like, we crossed some sort of bridge, and the bridge had went to the parking lot, the parking garage. We were like 30 or 40 people back. We were hoping that the doors would open soon, since, you know, it's almost time to, you know, see the show. But they literally didn't open it till 7. We stood outside in 30 degree weather for 30 minutes. I wish I would have taken more pictures during that time, or recorded something. That probably would have made sense, but I was too cold to think about that. They had opened the doors at 7, like I said. By the time we got up towards the door, like randomly somebody comes by and like slaps a box of just fans down. Everyone starts going towards it. So it's like, ah, I don't want to get out of line because somebody might cut me. So my friend Diana, like, she goes and grabs some stuff. And I was like, oh, great. I hope she got Mark. But I mean, she didn't get Mark, which was fine, I guess. So I end up getting pale, which is fine. We went in and finally, you know, we got our ticket scanned or whatever. We get to our seats. A lot of people are already in there, surprisingly. It was like almost packed when we got there. We had floor seats. So I was thinking, you know, yeah, we can see them, see their pores or whatever. But unfortunately for me, I'm short. Most of the time I was on my tippy toes. I could barely see over the person in front of me, but I still got to see some stuff. Concert was so amazing. Their energies. Obviously, when Mark came out, I was like, ah! I don't know if I have footage of that or not. And they perform some new songs. I like those songs. Hopefully they'll put those songs out because we need them. I don't remember any of the set list, not gonna lie. Like, I remember 10 did New Heroes and A Dream in a Dream. And Mark did Talk or Tell Them or... I don't know, a new song. Lucas did a new song. Taemin did a remix of Sherlock and Danger. But keep in mind, this happened like, what, 2 weeks ago or something? So my memory's a little fuzzy. But during Kai's solo, he was kind of doing a little dance thingy. Like, you know, for the first minute or two, I was like, all right, go Kai. And then like suddenly the lights like do some weird thing, like, cause the lights were like all red at one point. So it's like everything sort of looks the same. But then the lights change color for a moment, and I realized he was shirtless, and I was like, ah! So like I start like hitting Diana, and she's like, what the heck are you doing, girl? I didn't expect to do that myself, but that was too too surprising to me. Along with the ticket came an album, and my friend was lovely enough to give me that album as well. I showed this off in my K-pop album collection. You know, it does that thing, having an inception moment there. But yeah, it does that thing. Go watch my K-pop album thing, you'll see it better. Thank you for watching my experience going to the SuperM concert. I hope I can go to another one. I need to see Mark again up close. I love going to concerts, they're so fun, but I don't always get the opportunity to go. Like, I guess not too long ago, NCT was here and I wanted to go to that. And soon, 17 is coming and I can't go to that because it's like, oh my goodness, they expect $1 million for the tickets. Thank you for watching today. Leave a comment down there telling me about your most favorite concert experience. It's empty, you see that? You better make it not empty.
I'm still, like, I can't believe I'm standing with these guys right next to me. So anyways, thank you to the members. Oh, yeah. Thank you to you guys, and thank you to everyone. Thank you, Dallas.
See you guys later. Bye.